Both ourselves and our world are constantly changing. Depending on our mood, our age, our personality, we can often think and want different things. And at the same time, as our environment evolves around us, what it has to offer also changes. So it can be hard to figure out what the right thing to do is. Sometimes we rely on what we've done in the past to make a decision. But other times, especially when we suspect something may have changed, either in ourselves or in the world, we decide to try something new. We do this type of decision all the time, from what to order at a restaurant, to how to cut our hair, to who to marry. And when this decision process in our brain goes awry, the result can be profound. We even broadly refer to irrationality as the act of repeatedly doing something with the expectation of a different outcome. So clearly there is value in finding the right balance between relying on our previous experiences and adventuring to find new ones. My question to you is there an optimal balance? So that might sound like the stuff of philosophy, but it was actually mathematicians over half a century ago that became obsessed with solving this problem. They referred to it as the trade-off between exploring your world to find new information versus exploiting your current information. In 1952, it was famously formalized as the multi-armed bandit task, where a gambler in front of a row of slot machines must decide which machines to play and in what order to maximize payout over a certain amount of time. The slot machines, of course, have different reward probabilities, and so the gambler must figure out which machine to play to maximize payout, and it changes unexpectedly. So what's the best way to play this game? It turns out the effort to solve this actually resulted in the invention of a new field of artificial intelligence called reinforcement learning. And over the past half a century, statisticians and mathematicians have developed elegant algorithms that optimize how a robot can play this game. But we still don't really know how this decision process occurs in the brain. Are there collections of neurons performing the very same computations that we discovered with math and statistics? Or have our organic circuits evolved to implement an alternate solution? This is what we want to figure out. And I hope to show you today that we've developed a way to figure it out. During my PhD, I developed a multi-armed bandit task that a mouse can play, with nose ports instead of slot machines and water rewards instead of money. Here you can see the mouse play by poking its nose into the center port and then deciding to go left or right in an effort to get a water reward. Just like with the slot machines, the two nose ports have different reward probabilities that change unexpectedly over time. So the mouse must constantly switch between exploring the ports to figure out which one will give them more rewards and then exploiting that knowledge once it figures it out. So why bother going through all the trouble to teach a mouse how to play this task? Well, we need a way to record from a large number of neurons with very high resolution at the same time that an animal performs this task. And we can't do that yet in humans, but we're just starting to be able to do it in mice. To accomplish this, we're using some of the same technology that allows the cameras in your smartphones to be so small, but here it's used to construct tiny microscopes, just 2 grams, that a mouse can wear on its head and allows us to image the brain of a mouse while it's behaving. By engineering specific neurons to actually emit light when they're electrically active, we can literally watch hundreds of neurons flicker with activity as this mouse behaves. From this data, we can extract out the electrical information from each neuron and then align it to the behavior of the mouse and start to analyze what kind of information is this circuit encoding about whether an animal switches or stays, explores or exploits. Collecting this data set has been really, really exciting. And by analyzing it, we're poised to uncover our brain's algorithm for deciding whether or not we explore or exploit and compare it to those that we've programmed into our computers. I think we can all intuitively appreciate that this decision process, it changes from person to person, from mood to mood, and across different stages of life. It can also be profoundly different in conditions like autism, OCD, and addiction, where exploring is often avoided at high costs, and exploiting can spiral into loops of repetitive behaviors that are hard to break. It's my hope that by increasing our understanding of where this decision process occurs in the brain and by what strategy, we might be able to better understand what happens when it malfunctions in these conditions and what we might do to fix it when it does. Thank you very much.